Welcome to Adult Sleep Stories. Finding moments of peace in the hustle and bustle of our lives can be a big challenge. Our channel is your sanctuary, a place where captivating tales blend with soothing tones, guiding you toward restful slumber. Escape from the noise, let go of the day's stresses, and allow our stories to transport you to realms of tranquility and dreams. Whether you're seeking relaxation, meditation, or simply a good night's sleep, you're in the right place. So, settle in, close your eyes, and let the journey to serenity begin. In our unceasing journey through the corridors of life, moments of pure, unadulterated tranquility can sometimes seem as elusive as shadows at noon. The modern world is a symphony of endless noises, from the incessant hum of digital screens to the ceaseless whispers of obligations, commitments, and desires. In this symphony, our souls often search for a gentle lullaby, a melodious escape, a chance to pause, breathe, and simply be. Now, as you find yourself here in the magic of this narrative oasis, know that you've stumbled upon a sanctuary, a world where serenity isn't just a luxury but a promise. Picture, if you will, a secluded haven nestled amidst nature's embrace, where the wind hums lullabies and time itself seems to tread lightly. This is where we invite you to journey with us, a place of meditation, reflection, and utter calm. Begin by taking a deep, resolute breath. Feel the cool air grace your nostrils, traveling through the depths of your lungs, filling your being with the ancient rhythms of existence. And then, as you exhale, imagine releasing the shackles of worry, stress, and the relentless march of time. Each subsequent breath is a step deeper into the heart of tranquility, a dance with the universe, an affirmation of the present moment. We live in an era where the very essence of our existence often feels fragmented. Pulled in myriad directions by demands, expectations, and the invisible threads of technology, it's easy to lose oneself. But these tales, each a gem sculpted from the rich tapestries of imagination and insight, seek to offer you a bridge. A bridge not just to sleep, but that in itself is a cherished realm of restoration, but to a state of soulful relaxation, where the world narrows down to the here and now, where every heartbeat is a reminder of life's simple beauties. These stories are not just words. They are portals. They beckon you into worlds where the pace is gentler, the colors more vivid, and the sounds harmoniously aligned with the rhythms of the cosmos. Here, amidst these tales, you'll find characters and landscapes that resonate with the deepest parts of your psyche, invoking a sense of familiarity and nostalgia. They're like old friends or forgotten dreams, waiting to welcome you back. As you immerse yourself in these narratives, let the outside world fade into soft focus. Envision your stresses and anxieties as leaves carried away by a gentle stream, disappearing beyond the horizon. Let the weight of expectation, the clamor of responsibilities, and the noise of uncertainty be replaced by the soothing cadences of these stories. Every word, every phrase, is a brushstroke painting a world of peace, inviting you to step in and explore. Sleep, that precious gift, is not just a physical necessity but a balm for the soul. It's nature's way of healing, restoring, and rejuvenating. As you stand at the threshold of dreams, these tales are the gentle hands guiding you towards restful slumber. They remind you of the beauty of surrender, of letting go, of drifting into the comforting embrace of night. So, dear listener, as you embark on this journey with us, know that you are not alone. Through the magic of these tales, we are with you, sharing in your quest for tranquility and deep, restorative sleep. Let these stories be your anchor, your lighthouse, guiding you away from the tempests of daily life and into the calm waters of relaxation and dreams. Welcome to our sanctuary. Let the journey to serenity begin. The Story of the Lavender Garden. Chapter 1. The Lavender Reverie. Anna had always found comfort in the simple things, a book by the window on a rainy day, the laughter of children playing in the park, or the smell of the earth after a gentle rain. But today, she saw a new kind of solace, one that lay in the embrace of nature, in the sea of tranquility that was the village's famed lavender garden. The garden was more than just a plot of land. It was a testament to the dedication of generations who had tended to it, a living tapestry of flora that captured the very essence of pastoral beauty. The day was young, and the sun had just begun to climb, casting a soft golden glow over the earth. The sky above was an unblemished canvas of blue, promising the gentle warmth of a summer day. As she approached the gates, a faint scent teased her senses, a prelude to the olfactory symphony awaiting her. With every step, the scent grew stronger, an intoxicating blend of sweet and herbal notes that seemed to cleanse her worries and fill her with a sense of expectant calm. It was as if the very air whispered promises of peace and rejuvenation. Upon entering, Anna was greeted by an explosion of color. Rows upon rows of lavender stretched out in a meticulous array, creating waves of purple, lilac, and mauve that rippled with the morning breeze. The flowers, standing at attention, formed an army of serenity against the trials of life. The garden's design was deliberate, with narrow paths curving around beds of flowers, inviting visitors to lose themselves in its depths. Taking the leftmost path, she began her walk, her hands skimming the tops of the lavender plants. The blooms were in full glory, each cluster of tiny flowers a brushstroke of nature's art. Some stalks stood tall, their regal heads swaying slightly as if nodding to her presence. Others were more demure, huddled together and whispering secrets in hushed tones. Here and there, bees hummed diligently, their small bodies laden with pollen as they moved from flower to flower in an endless dance of life. Butterflies, too, graced the garden with their presence, the delicate patterns on their wings complementing the flowers they courted. Every so often, one would land on Anna's sleeve, its light touch a kiss from nature. As she ventured further, Anna discovered a small pond, its surface a perfect mirror reflecting the azure sky and the greenery that surrounded it. A family of ducks glided across the still water, their movements sending ripples through the reflected clouds, distorting the blue into moving art. She sat on a nearby bench, crafted from gnarled wood that spoke of age and elegance, and observed the dance of dragonflies skimming the water's surface. The gentle hum of their wings was a subtle counterpoint to the distant birdsong that filled the air. Anna's gaze then shifted to the field beyond the garden, where the lavender was wild and untamed, stretching towards the distant hills like a royal carpet. There, the colors were a deeper hue, unbridled and free, speckled with wildflowers that had claimed the land as their own. She imagined the hands that had toiled over the soil, planting and nurturing, and felt a surge of gratitude for their unspoken gift to the world. In the midst of this reverie, Anna noticed an elderly gardener, his hands withered like the wooden bench upon which she sat, moving with a grace that belied his years. He tended to the plants with a loving touch, each movement a benediction. She watched him prune a wayward stalk, his snips precise, guiding the plant's growth with practiced ease. Anna rose, drawn to the rhythm of his work. As she approached, the gardener looked up, his eyes a clear, bright blue, reminiscent of the sky above. They held stories, laughter, and a wisdom that came from a lifetime of communing with the earth. He smiled, and in that simple gesture, Anna felt an invitation to the heart of the garden, to the soul of the lavender that he so cherished. "Beautiful, isn't it?" he said, his voice as soft as the soil. "It's more than beautiful. It's alive," Anna replied, struggling to find words that could encompass the magic around her. The gardener nodded. "Each plant has a spirit, a voice that whispers to those who listen. They speak of old times, of love and loss, of the joy of rain and the warmth of the sun. If you stay quiet enough, you might hear them." Anna's walk continued, now accompanied by the stories the gardener had shared. She felt the whispers of the plants, the history of the land, and the myriad lives that had passed through this garden. Each step took her deeper, not just into the heart of the garden, but into her own interior landscape, a place of reflection where the beauty of the lavender found its echo in the peace she felt within. Chapter 2. Whispers and Wishes. The Garden of Lavender was not merely a sanctuary of tranquility. It was also a haven of memories and echoes of laughter that lingered in the air like the fragrance of the purple blooms. Anna found herself returning day after day, drawn by the garden's unspoken promise of a respite from the world's clamor. One afternoon, as the sun dappled through the rows of flowers, casting a kaleidoscope of light and shadow, Anna met an artist capturing the beauty of the garden on canvas. The artist, a woman with streaks of lavender and green in her hair, painted with a passion that was almost tangible, her brush strokes mimicking the dance of the butterflies over the blooms. Curious, Anna approached the artist, and a conversation blossomed as naturally as the flowers that surrounded them. The artist's name was Elise, and she spoke of her life in vivid hues, of travels and tribulations, of love found in the most unexpected places, and of solace sought in the embrace of nature. Elise's story was much like the lavender itself, a collection of experiences and moments that ranged from the deeply aromatic to the subtly sweet. She shared tales of her youth spent in the bustling streets of far-off cities, where the scent of lavender was a rare commodity found only in small boutique shops that lined cobblestone alleys. As they spoke, the boundaries of time seemed to blur, and the garden became a backdrop to the shared stories of two kindred spirits. Anna learned that the garden had been a retreat for Elise as well, a place where she found the inspiration to paint and the courage to face the canvas of her life, no matter how daunting it seemed at times. Together, they explored the garden, with Elise pointing out the different varieties of lavender, some known for their medicinal qualities, others prized for their particularly intoxicating scent. The heart of the garden was a secluded spot where the oldest lavender plants grew. It was a sacred space, a grove where time appeared to stand still. Here, the lavender grew wild and unrestrained, their scent so potent it seemed to carry the whispers of the past. Elise led Anna to the center of the grove, to an old stone bench that bore the marks of weather and age. It was here, Elise confided, that she came when her heart sought guidance, where she would sit and listen to the whispers of the garden. "Close your eyes," Elise said softly, her voice barely above the rustling of the leaves. "Listen to the lavender. It speaks to those who dare to hear." Anna did as she was told, her senses immediately engulfed by the essence of the garden. She listened, and in the stillness, she began to discern the faint murmurs of the earth, the rustling of petals, and the sound of distant memories echoing through the rows of lavender. The whispers spoke of lovers who had walked these paths, of poets who had composed odes to the beauty they found here, of weary travelers who had rested beneath the shade of the lavender and left refreshed. Each plant, it seemed, had been a silent witness to a thousand tales, each bloom a keeper of secrets. Anna opened her eyes with a newfound understanding of the garden's true beauty. It was not just in the visual splendor or the aromatic breeze. The garden's beauty lay in its ability to listen, to hold within its roots the essence of each person's story, to grow not just in soil but in the spirit of those who sought its comfort. As the sun began its descent, painting the sky in hues that rivaled the lavender itself, Anna and Elise remained seated on the stone bench. They talked of dreams and fears, of the future and the past, their voices adding to the chorus of whispers that the garden carried on the wind. The chapter would continue to delve deeper into the developing friendship between Anna and Elise, the history of the garden, and Anna's personal journey of introspection and discovery. There could be subplots involving the local community, the changing seasons affecting the garden, and perhaps a festival celebrating the harvest of lavender. Chapter 3: The Labyrinth of Paths. The labyrinth of paths within the lavender garden was not just a means to traverse its expanse, but a metaphor for life's intricate journey. Each turn held the promise of discovery, and each intersection, a choice. Anna found herself wandering these paths every day, the lavender a constant, the horizon filled with the hues of growth and change. One morning, as a gentle mist clung to the fields, she came across an old gardener tending to the plants with a tender, almost reverent touch. The gardener's hands were etched with the lines of time, and his eyes sparkled with a wisdom that seemed as deep as the roots of the lavender he cared for. "Beautiful, isn't it?" the gardener said, his voice a whisper, as if speaking louder would break the magic of the morning. "Each plant has its own tale, its own struggle, its own triumph. Much like us." Anna knelt beside the gardener, and under his guidance, she began to tend to the lavender. As she worked, the gardener spoke of the garden's history, of the soil rich with the stories of the past, and of the storms that had threatened to uproot everything, yet the lavender remained, steadfast and strong. The garden teaches us resilience, the gardener mused. It shows us that with care, patience, and a little bit of faith, we can weather any storm. His words resonated with Anna. She thought about the challenges she had faced, the moments when she felt uprooted, and how, like the lavender, she had found her strength, her will to stand tall again. The garden was not just a place of beauty, it was a teacher, a reminder of the cycles of life, the ebb and flow of hardship and ease. With the gardener's tales, Anna's understanding of the garden deepened. She learned about the cycles of the lavender, from planting to bloom to harvest, and how each phase was essential. She learned to recognize the signs of a plant in distress and how to nurse it back to health. Every lesson was a lesson about life itself. In the afternoons, children from the nearby village would come to the garden, their laughter a bright counterpoint to the serene atmosphere. Anna watched as the gardener showed them how to gently handle the plants, teaching them not just about gardening, but about caring, about the delicate balance of nature, and about their place in it. She saw the wonder in the children's eyes as they discovered ladybugs and bees working amidst the flowers, their young minds grasping the interconnectedness of all living things. And with every visit, the children left something behind, a small stone painted with a message of hope, a handmade wind chime that sang with the breeze, a promise to return. The days turned to weeks, and the garden became a canvas of changing colors and scents. Visitors came and went, each leaving with a piece of the garden's peace, and in return, they left behind their footprints, their whispered wishes, and their shared moments of joy and sorrow. Anna spent her evenings walking the labyrinth of paths, each time choosing a different route, each time discovering something new, a hidden bench, a view of the distant hills, the way the light filtered through the leaves of an old tree. The garden was alive, and with every step, she felt more connected to it, to its story, and to her own unfolding tale. The story continues on with Anna encountering a variety of visitors, each with their own connection to the garden, like a poet seeking inspiration, a couple celebrating their love, and an old woman reminiscing her youth. It would delve into the nature of the garden as a character itself, changing with the seasons, and explore deeper themes of growth, healing, and connection to the earth. Chapter 4. The Twilight Blossom. As the season transitioned from the fullness of summer to the cusp of autumn, the lavender garden began to change. The once vibrant purple hues mellowed into a softer palette, and the air carried a crispness that hinted at the coming chill. Anna's connection to the garden had grown deeper with each passing day, her spirit intertwined with the land and its cycles. During the twilight hours, Anna would often find herself seated on an old wooden bench, nestled between the rows of flowering lavender. It was during these quiet moments that the garden revealed its most intimate secrets. She had learned to understand the whispers of the wind as it danced through the lavender, each gust weaving stories of the past and dreams of the future. One evening, under a sky streaked with the colors of the setting sun, Anna met an artist whose easel stood tall amidst the flowers. His brushstrokes captured the essence of the garden, not just its appearance, but its soul. They spoke at length, and the artist shared his philosophy that to truly paint nature, one must listen to its voice. The garden speaks to us in colors and scents, the artist said, his gaze never leaving his canvas. Each brushstroke is a word, each color a sentence. Together, they tell a story of harmony and existence. Inspired by their conversation, Anna began to see the garden as a living painting, a masterpiece that was never quite finished. She understood that with every sunrise and sunset, the garden painted itself anew, offering a fresh vision for those who were willing to see it. The following mornings brought a new ritual. Anna would rise with the dawn to witness the garden awash in the golden light of the new day. She would walk barefoot, the dew-kissed earth cool beneath her feet, and watch as the nocturnal creatures retreated and the diurnal ones awoke. The garden at dawn was a different world, one of quiet anticipation and renewal. Anna's afternoons were spent documenting the garden. She started with sketches, her pencils lightly caressing the paper as she attempted to capture the curves and bends of the plants. Over time, she added watercolors, letting the hues bleed into one another, just as the garden's colors blended in nature. Her art became a diary, each page a love letter to the ever-changing beauty before her. The garden had visitors of all kinds, students on field trips, couples seeking a romantic backdrop, elders in search of tranquility. But there was one visitor who came as regularly as Anna, the old woman with eyes like the clear autumn sky. She would sit on the same bench each time, her hands gently folded in her lap, her presence a silent testimony to the years she had witnessed. One afternoon, as the woman gazed at the garden, Anna approached her with a cup of herbal tea made from the garden's finest. They spoke, and the woman recounted tales from her youth, of a time when the world moved at a slower pace, when people took the time to savor each moment like a precious drop of nectar. It's important to remember, the woman said, her voice as delicate as the lace on her collar, that every second is a gift, every breath a new chance. This garden, it knows the value of time. It does not rush, yet it blooms so magnificently. With each day, the garden became more than a place, it became a witness to life's ephemeral beauty, a custodian of moments both grand and minute. The lavender, with its resilient stems and tender blossoms, became a symbol of the delicate balance between strength and vulnerability. As the garden prepared to don its autumn cloak, the air filled with the scent of turning leaves and the promise of harvest. The lavender would soon be gathered, its oils extracted, but its essence would linger, both in the garden and in Anna's heart. The story is coming to an end with the harvest, the community coming together to collect the bounty of the garden, sharing stories, laughter, and the fruits of their labor. It would explore the concept of letting go, of understanding that every end is a prelude to a new beginning, much like the cycle of the seasons.